when you on top, gon' hate on you, that what they supposed to do. I don't know how to lose. Ay. I think the Rari go faster without the roof. Chill. 30, I might go around in 2 seconds up. I love how my money counter moves. With attitude, I got a bit too, and I dropped out of school. I'm going up, check my vertical. Man, I'm breaking every rule. TMZ harassing me, I got a camera crew. Whoa. I'm addicted to shopping, so everything brand new.
Everything brand new, yeah.
I'm friends with the jeweler, my diamonds like Shamu.
My diamonds like Shamu.
Hey, she like she applying shampoo.
Yeah.
Pretty face, she got a look.
She
too.
Got a look. Yeah.
Keep a few racks on me. I used to work in a factory. Been hating that never bother me. I make they follow me. Teacher said that I'm a prodigy. When I'm shopping, I don't care what it's costing me. 10 bands, really, that ain't a lot to me. Turn up my swag to infinity.
Damn.
I leveled up.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay, and this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Mason Crosby of the Packers has it teed up, and off we go from Lambeau. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. First and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. Forced out to his left. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play, but you know there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. On second down, Flacco to throw. Flush to his right. He's got the hook up to John Brown on the right side. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 16 yards on that one at a Raven first.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Throwing here on first down, Flacco. That's caught by the former Sooner, Mark Andrews. The 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Mark Andrews, 54 yards. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
A note on Aaron Jones, by the way, Charles, it kind of surprised me. He actually led the NFL this season at 5.5 yards per carry.
He's one of those players that doesn't get mentioned nearly often enough for his explosiveness. But when he touches the football, good things happen for the Green Bay Packers. Unfortunately, didn't play in the early part of the season, then got hurt in the late part of the season. All this production had to come in the middle. 728 rushing yards and 8 touchdowns. I'd love to see his production over a 16-game schedule.
Rodgers now on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that'll make it second and short.
Now that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. They'll pitch it out to Jones. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Not your normal call in short yardage, but the toss works well there. Big people out in front, being physical, and they pick up a first down.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Rodgers to throw on second down. The left side throw complete to Adams. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So first and 10 now from the 30. Rodgers now on first down. This will be caught inside the 10. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football. And they've got it here with a first down. Now Jones. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rush would just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
He's going to get it running right, and he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Call it no gain that time, and now it's third and goal. So now it's third and goal. This Raven defense trying to keep him out of the end zone. They'll try to run it in with Jones. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Only 1 yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. Rodgers to throw for it on 4. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. When I saw the pressure coming at him, that just looked problematic. Hit him as ruined, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy and can he step into a throw. And when you can't do that, oftentimes, interceptions result.
For Baltimore, Charles, if you look back to this season, it was pretty interesting. They start 4-5. You think John Harbaugh may not be there. He's on thin ice. Joe Flacco's at quarterback. But then Lamar Jackson comes in, and everything changed. Their whole offense changed.
It certainly did because of the infusion of speed at the quarterback position. And throws the ball a little bit better from the pocket than maybe he got credit for. Has to get better at that. But I think people had to adjust because Joe Flacco is a quarterback. You knew where he would be every time. 3 to 5 steps behind center, you could go get him. With Lamar Jackson, he could be anywhere in big play.
So after the second down completion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Operating out of the gun, Flacco finds his target, Montgomery. And they'll get him down up past the 15, just shy of the 20.
It's a pickup of 11 at a Baltimore first. First and 10 here for Flacco. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Sliding out of the pocket. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. That one was intended for John Brown, and it's third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. Eluding the pressure right, throwing the out route incomplete. It's Andrews. And all the way down to the 35. A big-time third down play for the Ravens. 45 yards. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. They look to throw on first and 10 with Flacco. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. Space to run past the 20. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it's a second down. Flacco will take to the air again, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and that'll bring up a third down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Michael Crabtree, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Earlier, Charles, we were mentioning about how Green Bay missed the playoffs this last year. You know, they had made the playoffs 8 straight years, 2009 to 2016. But now 2 straight years without going to playoffs. And when you're playing in a town called Titletown, USA, I don't know that you're accustomed to that.
This feels to them, even though it's just been 2 years, this feels like the days when they went through former legends leading them. Bart Starr, Forrest Gray, even Lindy Infante came in, had a 10-win season, but none of those were in a playoff appearance. A lot more years then, the Packers don't want to get back to that now. This cost Mike McCarthy his job. The new head coach wants to set a new direction and get the Packers back in the playoff picture.
A good pickup there at 22. First down carry by Jones. And across midfield he goes into Raven territory. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And Adams has it complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Rodgers finding Adams for a Packer first. So we've hit our mission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will not be turnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off here by Jimmy Smith. And he will score. Touchdown, Baltimore. This D wanted to put it away before we even get to the fourth quarter, ending that margin a bit further.
And while they won't just empty the bench just yet, if you're a backup, start loosening up. I think you'll get a chance to play before this one is over now with that type of a cushion.